guys, today we'll be discussing about core Java training. Okay, so this course will be containing a core Java portion. As we are aware that Java is segregated into three parts. Okay, core Java, advanced Java, and for mobile unit also we are discussing. But in this training program, we'll be discussing about the key drive concept of core Java. So this will be the demo section, which I'll be trying to explain you to some PPTs. Okay, so it will be helpful for you. So we are providing training from VR Mind Magic. We are having 9+ years of experience. Like more than 4+ lakhs of students have already enrolled with us. Okay, and we have already around 550+ courses we are providing, in which we have technical courses, we have professional courses also. It is a you can visit our website also. Okay, mindmagic.com. So the curriculum of this course. This course is having some strong concept. Okay, this course is starting from beginner level to advanced level in core Java. Okay, I'll be starting from introduction to Java. What is Java? Who has developed this? What are the terminology? What are the naming conventions do we have in this? What are the features of Java we could have? Okay, and these all things we'll be discussing under this introduction to Java portion. After that, we'll be moving to this data types. Data types are nothing but is used to restrict the space for variable into memory. Basically, if I'll not tell you in technical language, basically to identify what type of variable it could be, like it could be int, byte, short, long, float, double, bool, char, kind of variables we could have. So what are the ranges for this, what type of values, what is the maximum limit, what is the minimum limit, okay, what are the default values we could store, what are the classes names, what is signed bit, what is unsigned bit, that we'll be discussing under this data type. After this, we'll be discussing these operators. Any programming language does not exist, they are not having operators, because operators are one of the important aspects where we can perform some certain tasks. So like in Java, we have so many operators. When I'm saying that, it means we could have assignment operators, we could have, like, if I have to segregate into different sections, then I can say like we could have arithmetic operators, we could have conditional operators, we could have relational operators, ternary operators, like logical operators we could have. In logical operators, we are discussing about the AND operators, OR operator, NOT operator, AND OR operators, like not equal to kind of thing, we'll be discussing under this operators part. After that, we'll be having instructions part. So, what are instructions? So, as it seems to be very simple, like what are instructions, like whenever we have to perform some task, okay, that is instruction, but that is not. Okay, instructions, under instructions, we'll be discussing the conditional statement. Conditional statements are nothing but when we have to verify or check some condition, we are using conditional statements. What are the conditional statements we could have, like if condition, if else condition, if else if or nested if also we have switch cases. When we have to perform more number of conditions, when we have to perform more than 5, 6, 7 terms of conditions in one go, then we are using switch statements. In instructions only, we'll be giving you training on loops, like for loop, tested for loop, while loop, okay, while loop, that type of loops, okay, what is the use, how to initialize it, that all things we'll be discussing under this instruction. We are saying them as decision control, like statements also, or decision control instructions also, but we could have different number of different type, different name. Everything should be covered under this instruction. So next portion will be functions or methods. We'll be discussing what are methods, how to create methods. There can be, will you be able to execute the program without main method in Java? This type of like random questions, what recruiters may ask you at the time of interview. What are the reusable method? What is the predefined method? What is user defined method? What is static, non-static kind of thing? Keywords. What are the keywords we could have? That will be discussed under this function part. What are the type passing? Type passing is one of the very important concepts we are discussing. Like when we have bigger size value, like let's say when you have to identify the speed of light for 1 year, like 365 multiplied by whatever is the value. Okay, 10 to the power 13. I'm not sure about the numbers because I'm not bothered about it. Let's say if it is the concept, what I'm trying to explain here is like it is more as the range of int. Let's say if int is supporting 10,000 and it is this number is like 10 lakhs, then how I can score this? What is narrow type casting? We could have different set of data, right? When we have sometimes we could have small data, sometimes we could have bigger data when we have to go in small container and vice versa also. Okay, so that is all about type casting. It is also one of the very important concepts. Okay, and OOPS concept. OOPS is nothing but object oriented programming. So is Java supporting 100% OOPS concept? No, it is not. Why? We'll be discussing at the time of our session. Okay, so what are the OOP concepts we could have, that is class, method, objects, packages, inheritance, abstractions, polymorphism, these concepts, encapsulation, we'll be discussing here. What are the variables, what are the different types of variables we could have, that we'll be discussing. What are the constructors, what are the destructors, okay, we'll be discussing. Constructor is nothing but a special kind of method, even though if you are not creating it, it will be automatically created, okay. What are the this and super keyword, what is go-to keyword, we'll be discussing. In this course curriculum only, we'll be discussing about the garbage collectors, how GC will be initialized. Like, this is nothing but the garbage collector, okay, how it will be working, and how to take the data from like the input, like the scanner class, the reader, different sources we could have, how to take the data from user. Okay, what is package, what are the different types of predefined packages, what are built-in packages, both the same only, but slight difference we could have. Here, when I'm saying predefined and built-in, I'll explain it at the time of session only. And what are the user-defined packages, okay, what are the naming conventions for this, what are the structure of the program, Java inner classes, interface, array, command line argument, it is a very useful, but sometimes a few organizations those are having older framework. There we are using command line arguments, there we are passing. While I have added it in my curriculum, what are the static blocks, is it Niger block, okay, what is multi-threading, what is exception handling, how to perform error handling kind of thing, what are the keywords, zone, throwable kind of thing, try, catch, block, okay, that we'll be discussing here. What are input, output, passing, what are collection framework. In collection framework, here also I'll explain you. Also at the time of project discussion, I'll explain you the whole framework under this for this collection, okay. What are the strings, okay, string classes, what are the different string methods we have. That we'll be discussing under this section. Post completion of this session, I'll be explaining you how to write the program which they may ask you at the time of interview. So some Java examples, some interview tapes, interview questions, mock interviews we'll be preparing. So this is how we'll be handling this core Java to work with, and I'm sure it will be a great learning for you. It will not be a boom session, at least I can say that. So this is all about in this course curriculum section. The next topic will be today's agenda. So that is the first topic which we have, that was introduction to Java. Java is a object-oriented programming language. Although we are saying, but it is not 100% because it is not supporting 100% proof concept. Why it is not supporting, we'll be discussing. But if I have to explain you about Java, then it is an object-oriented programming language. Initially, it was developed by Sun Microsystems. It was an IT company, but later on, it was acquired by Oracle. Nowadays, it will be downloading JDK or something. If you will be able to access it from Oracle only, okay? And what are the features and the properties of Java? So it is secure. Okay, it is platform independent. Okay, different types of properties we could have with this Java. Okay, how to perform compilation, how to do interpretation for this, what is in platform independence, it is secure. Also, sandbox model is supporting. What is sandbox model? I cannot explain it here because it's a bit bigger model, but just it is supporting that sandbox model also. So, this is the introduction of core Java. You could have so many different things in this, but I have to cover the basics as it is a demo title only. Now, what is platform independence? It is a very good topic in my aspect. Most of the time, recruiters will be confusing you basically because most of the people are not aware with the exact meaning of platform independence. So, first of all, before telling you this, okay, let me tell you how the program is going to be. First, we are writing the program, we are saving the file with .java format, and then we are compiling. Let me tell you, if I have to explain it like that. Let's say this is the biggest number program I have to write. What I'll be doing, first I'll be writing the program and I'll be saving the file with .java format or .java extension. What I'll be doing, then I'll be doing the compilation part. Okay. This is the path. Okay. Let me copy this. What I'll be doing, I'll be simply going to that path, slash, okay. So for Java, we have one compiler. Generally, we are using that is Java 2, so Java 2, and then class name, the biggest number dot Java. Let's say you can see here we have all the classes. Okay, the extension or type of these files is Java file. Let me run it. It will be compiling my file. Okay, and then what will be the output for this? See here, one new dot class file has been generated. So what it is, so first, as I told you, first we are writing the program, okay, we are saving the file with .java format, then we are compiling it, okay. So after compilation, this dot class file will be generating. What is this dot class file? This dot class file is also called as bytecode. So this bytecode we are passing to my JVM, and my JVM will be executing my program, okay, and then I'll be getting the output. So the summary of this story is like, this dot class file is platform independent, means you can write the program anywhere, you can compile it, and then you can share the dot class file with any environment, and you will be able to execute your program. So basically, if you have to say like, what is platform independence, that we still now understood that primary function of JVM is to execute bytecode produced by compiler, right? Now, each operating system has its own JVM, means for each and every environment, we could have different JVM. Means for Windows, we could have different, for Linux, we could have different, for macOS, we could have different JVM. But the output they produce after executing the bytecode same across all the operating means, the output will be same, okay? Whatever output you can get from here, the same will be from macOS, from Linux also, but it is not supported with other programming languages. It is not supported by older programming languages, okay? That is why we call Java as platform independent language. I hope it was clear. The deeper manner how it is actually working, that we will be seeing in our practical section. So the next topic is our data types. What are the data types? As we discussed at the time of discussing the curriculum portion, data types are nothing but it is like we have to space into memory for my variable. So we are using data types to preserve or to allocate the space for the variable into memory. That is the reason while creating the variables, we should specify the data type in Java. So that, based on the data type, system will allocate the space to that variable into memory. And like based on range, actually, we have 8 different types of data types in Java. Like starting from lowest to biggest, like 5 short and long. These data types are useful to store the integer value. For float, for decimal value, we have a float and double. And character is for storing the single character. And boolean is to store the true and false values. Okay. I hope this is clear. And what's the maximum range? What's the minimum range? What is the predefined class for this? And what is the base class for this? What is the biggest number which we can store? Okay. What is typecasting? We'll be seeing typecasting actually. The part of this data types only. So I hope it is clear, okay, and we'll see this also in our slide. Core Java introduction portion is for 30 hours, okay. Time you can contact with MindMagic, for fees also you can contact with them, okay. What this course is included, okay, what we are providing, okay. So this course will be containing daily instructor based live action, okay. We can provide you the recorded video sessions also after completion of the course. You can you will be getting the class notes, assignment sheets, practice sessions, okay. Even now we are providing doubt solving sessions also along with interview preparation. If you are interested for this, you can join us in that doubt solving session. It is not one-on-one, but you can join us, okay. It doesn't mean if we are conducting this doubt solving session, it doesn't mean that you can ask questions. You can definitely ask any number of questions you can ask. I'll be happy to answer all the questions. But yes, this is one new thing which we have started, the doubt solving problem. We are preparing for some specific company in that case. Okay. Now, what is the market of Core Java? If you can see from this chart, okay, Java is very older. First of all, Java is a very old programming language compared to recent languages like Python, okay, JavaScript. Still, if you can see the graph, okay, the market share, okay, the demand of this Java is still increased, right? Even more than Python, C#, JavaScript, we have a huge demand for Java. So market is very good. Please come, join, and learn and start doing exploring the new things of Java. Okay. Now, you'll be after completing this session, you'll be getting the course completion certificate, which you can attach in your organization, or you can add in your CV also. It will be helpful for you in your upcoming project. And let me explain you how Java works. As I explained you what is platform independence, okay, how the program will be executing. So first, we are writing the program. Either you can write in a notepad or in the editor, like Eclipse IDE, like I nowadays people are using in IDE because it is a bit easier for you to write the program. Okay, so we are writing the program in this Eclipse editor nowadays, but the main real flow is like, first we are writing the program in Notepad, then we are saving it with .java extension as I explained in previous slide. Then we are compiling with JavaScript compiler, okay? And then after compilation, one file will be generated. That is nothing but .git, that file. That file's format is .class file. The code which is contained inside that class file is called as bytecode. And now we need to execute this class file by using the command called java.file, and you will be getting the output, okay? And in our IDE, generally we are not following this process, but this is the actual reality. Okay, nowadays, they must be asking you, any of these product-based companies, they are asking, are you aware with the reality how Java should work? Okay, or you are just writing code in a place. The real programmer is the one who can write and can execute and can print the value from command line or from this notepad. Because in IDE, it is very easy for you to guess the method name, get the errors, okay, which you are doing at the time of writing the program. But yes, it is a old approach, but still it is a real. Okay, now we need to execute this, after executing this bytecode, we'll be getting the output. And who is providing the output? My JVM is providing me this output. Basically, what JVM is doing is, JVM is converting my bytecode of this class file into machine readable or machine understandable format. This is also called interpretation or interpreter. Okay, you can call it with any name. So this is how Java does work. Although it's a random topic, if you are a serious people, if you are a serious person, then you are. Okay, so this is how Java works. Write the program, save it or Java extension, and compile it with JavaScript compiler, get the file and class file format, then provide this dot class file to your JVM, and it will be converting the bytecode of this class file into specific machine readable format, and will be getting your output. That's all about it. This is how Java should work. Okay. What are the projects which will be discussing? Actually, in core Java, when we are learning a core plus advanced Java, we will be having very fancy projects. Okay? But when we are learning only a core Java, we have some limitations for projects. So because it's the base building concept, core Java is the base building concept. Your base will be clear. You'll be able to write the program. You'll be able to execute. You'll be able to debug. You'll be able to handle the exceptions kind of things. Okay, so the project which I'll be explaining here, that the whole collection framework, a full framework explanation I'll be doing, other than the course in which I'll be explaining the collection. Okay, so in this collections, okay, what I'll be covering, I'll be explaining the whole packages, what are the predefined classes, interfaces, okay, and how you can modify the collection according to your requirement. This is the one important topic in this framework we'll be discussing. And also one small project that will be that online reservation system, okay. We'll be reviewing the project requirements, we'll be doing the setup, like database, what I know, which database is required for this, and then we'll be connecting to our IDE, and then we'll be creating the script, and then I'll be showing you how this online reservation system is working. We'll be merging all the components as well. When I'm saying that connectivity establishing, that means merging with all the components, and so these are two projects which we'll be discussing during this session. Okay, so a lab setup is not much more not much things required for this. Prerequisite, single reason to learn Java. Again, I'm saying, and even I'm not expecting you to know anything. I'll be starting from the scratch, and I'll be giving you up to advanced level training. Okay, normal in Windows, Mac, or Linux, you can we can download and install this Java, okay? And 4 GB of RAM and 5 GB of free disk space. So that is very basic. Although I guess in every PC would have this adaptive requirement, this type of system, okay, architecture we could have, okay? And this also we need a few tools to work with core Java. Okay, nothing but first we'll be doing the installation part. In this installation part only, we'll be doing this environment variable setup, okay? And then Eclipse IDE, Tenji, Maven, I'll be explaining you. Even I'll be explaining you GitHub also, okay? How to do versioning control in this aspect. That will be not in a very standard form, or not in a very explained manner. It will be a bit like how to upload the code and all. Now, what are the mock interview questions for this? Although, at the time of session, when you'll be joining our session, we'll be providing you almost all possible interview questions, okay? But today, as we discussed about core Java and how JVM or Java programs are working, the questions related to that only we will be discussing. What is Java? Can I answer now? What Java requires for Selenium? This is basically, Selenium is nothing but one automation tool. Okay, so core Java is required for this. Okay, what is the latest version of Java? Yes, definitely. And what is the difference between JDK, JRE? Yes, JRE is a part of JDK only. what is JVM Java Virtual Machine? JVM is useful to execute the program and produce the output. It is basically converting the class file code or byte code to machine readable format. What is the difference between path and class? This is related to the system variable, environment variable which we are creating. Don't worry, at the time of section, I'll explain you. What is structure of Java program? Okay, how many data types we have in Java? What is switch case in Java? These kind of questions we could have. Even after completion of every session, I'll be explaining you almost all possible questions. Okay, so don't worry about the question side. We'll be providing you full support from our end. And that's all about guys for today's session. Okay, hope to see you soon. Thank you so much. Bye.